Principle number two is your idea is just not that relevant. So when you're looking at product, product really doesn't matter that much. It's always about the people. Sustainable startups, 100% of the time, always about the people, not about the product. And so to get that, to really focus yourself in as an entrepreneur or a management team, to focus yourself in on that, you need three things, and that's vision, values, and alignment. And so the number one question, so vision is actually made up of three questions, but the number one question of vision is, why does your startup exist? And not every startup is going to be out there to save the whales or save the rainforest, right? It's impossible for everybody to do that. But you have to figure out what one thing your company does, your startup does, and focus on that. Why does it exist? Why is it doing what it's doing? And so the other questions you have to ask yourself is, what difference does it make in the world? Right? It doesn't have to save the whales. It could just be making email a little bit faster or freeing up a few seconds here and there between, you know, getting into your car and your car starting. Right?
It has to make a difference.
It has to, right? Yeah. It can't just be another follow-on product, right? It's not a bolt-on, it's not tiny, it's gotta do something. And the important question, against what, not who, does your startup compete? So when you focus on the individual companies, you get distracted from the overall goal, right? You're focused on competition, not creation. And the number one thing is always focus on creation and the people.
I think a great point there that you brought up, Jamie, is talking about, not just build, what difference does it make? It's huge, because if the difference is, it really starts to differentiate if you're just building an app or if you're building a company. Mm-hmm. And if you're just building an app, not that that's a bad thing, you know, your sustainability and the size and the scope of the project is much different than if you're actually building a company.
Yeah. Yeah, when you're purely building a feature, you're opening yourself up to get taken over and eaten very quickly by the large competitors in the marketplace. So the second part of principle two is building a core set of values. And values essentially are the compass that guides all startups. So mainly we say, you know, pick three values that really align your team. For us, it's courage, authenticity, and respect, because they focus in what we're doing as a company and really move us forward. And without these values, you start to lose sight and lose track of where you're going, hence the little compass that we threw in there.
Yeah, sorry, I changed the slide on you too
quick. That's all right. And the last part of principle two is all about alignment. So it's great to have your vision and your values, but you're building a team. And the number one piece of alignment is the communication of your vision and values. If you can't do that, then there's really no sense in building your vision and values. Alignment is how you communicate to yourself, to your team, and to your investors or your competitors, users, about what your company does and what it's truly about. So this is a nice shiny bus. This is how Cam and I got to the presentation today. It looks great on the outside. And this is what vision and values does. It looks great on the outside. But without alignment, having all your seats in row and everyone on board knowing where you're going, it doesn't do anything. It's just a shiny shell on the outside.